Well, hi. Thank you for being here. Thank you for joining me again today on Influences, where we're just looking to encourage and motivate you in your walk with God and your journey in life. And today we are continuing our series on moving out of the crowd. As I said before, and as you may have seen in preliminary videos, this is really to sort of explore the ways in which we ourselves can move away from the crowd and to recognize that we ourselves need to improve our life. We're reading today from the book, as I said, Moving Out of the Crowd, second book that I wrote, and page 26, it says, the types of crowds. By now, you should all have probably determined some crowds in your life. Lately, I have had to stop and evaluate my personal life. It was there that I realized that I needed to make a hard decision to move away from my personal crowds. It is my conclusion that the following are popular crowds in our lives. While all may not necessarily relate to you, some just might. So listen to some of the crowds that I'm talking about here. Thoughts can be crowds. Church community, yep, I said it. Social groups and relationships. Social media. Entertainment / noise. The need to belong. Past experiences or life occurrences. Fear. We'll talk about that. So these are some of the crowds. And I'm sure if you think about it, you'll find a few others that you could probably list that could possibly be crowds in our lives. The question is, out of the list that I've read here, where do you see yourself? Are there any things that you find yourself in that you could define as crowds? Are there any of those that I singled out that you can possibly say, yes, that's a crowd in my life and I need to do something about it? And of course, in the book, I continue to talk about how thoughts, how fear, how all the various things, social media, noise, entertainment, and all of that, how they can possibly be crowds in our lives. I ask you to explore, think about you. Is there anything that is crowding your space to produce, your space to create, your space to be the person that God wants you to be? Rather, you spend your time more into them than in working on yourself. If that is the case, you know, I want to say to you, you have to make the effort, you know, to connect as far as with those crowds so that it becomes a better place for you as it pertains to grow, as it pertains to improving on your life and your walk with God. So I encourage you, think about any of these and more. For some people, it's drug addiction. For some people, it's alcoholism, which is also a drug addiction. There are lots of things, truly, that people may engross, get ourselves engrossed in, which may serve as crowds in our lives, because what they do is they prevent us from actually, you know, being our full, meeting our full potentials and being the true people that God wants us to be. Having said that, I urge you to consider your crowds and work on allaying, getting rid of some of them. Okay, so for example, on the thoughts, I'm referring to thoughts, the things that we think about. It says if thoughts are like crowds, then how does one get away from them? This seems impossible because they are always with us everywhere we go. But it is a difficult procedure to flee from our thoughts. What we can do is change them from negative to positive, hatred to love, darkness to light. I know this is difficult, but I propose what Christ offers to us. And Romans chapter 12, verses 1 to 2 tells us, I beg you, through the mercy of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, so that you may judge what is God's will, what is good, pleasing, and perfect. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So that scripture verse, I think, really brings on the importance of renewing our minds and of the importance of renewal of our minds. So I urge you today to pray for the grace to have a renewed mind. Pray for the grace to conquer the thoughts that tend to try to bring you down. Conquer the thoughts that are negative and that are not life-giving. Conquer the thoughts that are, you know, just destructive, truly. So I urge you to consider doing that as well. That's my prayer for you, as it is for myself, that we may have happy thoughts, that we may have wholesome thoughts. All right, so that's my prayer. Thank you for watching. Let me pray with you before you leave. Father in heaven, I thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to think. Thank you that you've given us a brain as part of all beings. Thank you for every brain cell, every tissue, nerve ending of all bodies. Father, we pray today that you will grant us new thoughts. Renew our minds that we may have thoughts that are pleasing to you, thoughts that are wholesome, thoughts that are pure, thoughts, Lord Jesus, that will uplift us and not bring us down. We commend these thoughts to you, Lord Jesus, that we may have a more fulfilled life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. May God bless you. Thank you for coming by. If you enjoyed this video and the encouragement that you received, for I sure hope you did receive some level of encouragement, please feel free to go ahead and share it with other people. Share the link and also subscribe. Subscribe to the channel if you've not yet done so, so that you may also receive more encouragement whenever I post a video. And also feel free to share it with your friends so that they too will benefit from just this sharing that I have had to you today. Okay, so thank you and God bless. See you around. Come again. We will have another word of encouragement for you going forward. God bless you.